Risk disclaimer. Hello, what's going on, my friend? This is your friend Emmanuel Adebola, aka the Forex Apostle, and I want to welcome you to this week's video where we'll be looking into swing trading with Tradermatic, and we're going to be giving an example of 101 case scenario that I had with one of my 101 clients. And I mean, you grow and enjoy this, okay? However, you also know that today, being Monday, we're going to be randomly selecting another winner for our palliative cash gift. I hope you stay to the end of this video because that winner might be you. Also, if this is the first time you are visiting our channel, come on, show us some love. Click on the button below this video. Subscribe to this YouTube channel. We want to get it to 10,000 subscribers before December this year. Also, click the bell so that you'll be notified when next we upload new video. We try to provide information, good value, valuable information for you every day on this channel. And of course, you don't want to miss any of them. So I'm going to give you 30 seconds to do that. Then we'll continue this video.
Good morning. My name is Destiny Ajala, the second time winner of Mr. Emmanuel Adegola's palliative cash gift. I would like to say a very big thank you for this gift. I truly appreciate it, and I say God bless you. Please keep the information and training coming because we are really gaining from it, and I am gaining from it. Thank you very much, sir.
So now I set my alarm for 5 o'clock, as you can, I don't know if you can see. That's one of my alarm right there. You see the alarm that I set right there?
Yes,
five alarm that I set. The first one is 1:30. The 1:30 is for me to wake up for London session. I set another one for 1:40. That is in case I did not wake up by 1:30. 1:40 home, we come up again. Then I set another one for 1:50. So if I miss the 1:30, I miss the 1:40, the 1:50 home. So, or in most cases, except I just decide that, okay, I'm not going to, I don't want to stand up myself. That's why I won't start get up. Then, if there's any news that's coming up, let's say there's going to be news like 3 a.m. or 3:30 a.m., I have one that I adjust based on that news. So I will set it like 5 minutes before that time. Then, of course, I have another one that I set for 5:45 a.m. The 5:45 a.m. is to wake up to help with the kids sometimes, not all the time, but at least sometimes. Then I now have the one for 5 p.m. So the one for 5 p.m. immediately comes up. If I want to swing trade, it's for me to come to my computer. So that 5 p.m., because that is when the new day, the new market is opening, like in Australia. If you go now and you look at the time, what is the time now in Australia? So this will be current time. Let's see. So current time in Australia now, you can see it's 8:09. So the market is just starting over there. So, and that is why we have, this new candle for me. So what I do, I have these pairs that are already lined up. You can see BTC, USD, USD Tech. Sometimes I'll look at daily. I'll go down to 4 hours to see what is going on 4 hours. So as you can see, on 4 hours right now on Bitcoin, you can see it's bullish, but I will not be buying. Why? Because of this candle right there. It's red candle. If I go to 1 hour now, definitely you see that, you can see that long candle right there. So then I will go to indices. You can see normally it's bullish. On 4 hours, I go to 4 hours also to see what is happening right there. It's also bullish. right? Mm-hmm. But it's not an ideal situation for me to say, okay, I'm going long. If I want to go long, it has to be, remember, I have to reduce my risk. So, right. So if I'm going long here, let's say I want to go long with this now. So let's say this is where I enter the trade. Then definitely, where will you expect me to put my stop loss?
If you go long right now on that, mm-hmm. I would expect you to put your stop loss over there where you have that Phoenix, the red.
This one, right?
Oh no! Oh, below it. Yeah. Sorry.
So somewhere there.
Somewhere below it, yes.
Yeah, somewhere here. So when you look at that, okay, you will see there is a lot of pips right there. So right. That's why I always want something very number one, very close. Then another thing that I discovered that burnout account is money management. You see, if you are trading on 5 minutes, let's say. Your account is 10,000.
Mm-hmm.
And you are trading on 5 minutes chart.
Mm-hmm.
And on this 5 minutes chart, this 10,000, you are able to trade 1.0 lot size.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? 1.0 lot size. Now, when it comes to, I say 5 minutes, right? It's like we've used 4 minutes, 30 seconds now. Okay.
Okay.
So now, if you are now trading on a higher time frame, like a daily chart,
mm-hmm.
4 hours chart, you will not be trading 1.0 lot size. This one here, you'll be trading like 0.1 size.
0.1, okay.
0.1 size, you see? So, and that is the way to do it. So it therefore means that on an account like this one, this account, this is $62,751, okay. Right? This mm-hmm. account, if I'm entering any long position, any position on swing trading on this account, mm-hmm. I will do 0.6.
Okay.
And somebody say, oh, really? On 62,000 accounts? Yes, because the truth remains that, okay, if I'm entering a trade, let me just count through and see if we have any trading opportunity first. Okay, so let's say this GBPAUD now. Mm-hmm. If I'm going long on this GBPAUD, which we can actually do, you know, this is 4 hours, even though I know it will come back down, but on a longer term, we are bullish on this pair. So if I'm going long now on this pair, let's just, it's a live account that I'm willing to take that risk. So if I put 0.6, okay, and I click on buy,
mm-hmm.
now I've bought right now.
Mm-hmm.
Now look at what I'm risking. My margin is $392.48.
Okay.
But that is not what I'm risking. What I'm risking, right? You see, when you place a trade and you lost the trade, you will lose both your what you risk in this place and most of the times the margin you put down.
Right. Okay.
But when you win, of course, this your margin come back to your account. Does that make sense?
Yes.
That is why you will see free margin. Free margin now is your balance minus the margin you are using.
Okay.
Do you see that? So right. Now, when you see that, now we want to put a stop loss. I can put my stop loss. Okay. Normally, if I want to do it, will be below this lowest low. I know someone will say, okay, why not below this box? But the truth of the matter is that it can just one move like this can, if I'm doing swing trading, in fact, most of the time I don't even use stop loss, but let's say, okay, I want to use stop loss with this.
Okay.
Now, my stop loss will come below this. And the reason is very simple. You see this Phoenix, this green one,
mm-hmm.
I would be expecting a big red one on top before we exit this trade.
Okay.
Let me show you, like here. You see the red one? That is the big one there.
Uh-huh.
You see how far it moves down?
Yes.
before you see this one, that wow. is 3,094 pips.
Wow.
So I'm expecting this one now, the way it moves, this trade I open right now, and I'll keep you posted on this trade because it's not a trade that will last for just one day, 2 days. Now, if I want to put stop loss, my stop loss will be below here. So my stop loss will be somewhere like this,
right.
which will be like, let's see, let's put a stop loss and see what we are risking there. So my stop loss will be like a one. So stop loss will be 1.75525. Okay. Then my take profit will be, now what I told you guys is that you look into your left, the next bullish box you see will be your take profit. So this will be my next bullish box right there.
Okay,
that will be my next bullish box. After this one, this will be my next one.
Right, okay.
After that, this will be my next one. So just to be more conservative, I can use this one. So that will give me, so I'll be looking to, let's say, something like a 1.95322. Let me just put it 320. Okay. So that would be my take profit. So what do I do? I'll right click, then I will click on modify. Then my stop loss now will be 1.75525. My take profit here will be 1.95320. Then I will say modify. So now when you look at this trade, okay, this is a $62,000 live account. Now I have some robots that I also use on this account anyway that trade for me. Uh-huh. But on this manual trade now, this is what I'm risking.
Right.
I'm risking 3,000, you see?
Wow.
I'm risking $3,332.
Wow.
And take a look at it. We just put 0.6 lot size.
Right.
So now imagine if I put 6.0 lot size. So it therefore means that I'll be risking almost $33,000.
Wow. So there is no chance for a $1,000 account on swing trade.
There is a chance if you have a $1,000 account.
Mm-hmm.
You can be trading on like something like 0.01 accounts, but you have to be very, very tight on that account, because if you have $1,000 account and you want to do swing trading, then you cannot use like daily. You can go back to 4 hours and trade on 4 hours.
Okay.
So if you trade on 4 hours, of course, remember like this now, 4 hours, this market, don't be surprised, it can still come back down.
Right.
It can still come back down, then continue. Now, take a look at where our stop loss is.
Wow.
There's no way I will wait for this market to come, and eat my stop loss. So that is why if you are trading on 4 hours, I mean, you can do swing trading even on 1 hour. You just remember the swing means you are partaking of that swing. This is a swing. Like right now, this is a swing.
Mm-hmm.
This is a swing. In fact, this is a swing on its own. This is a swing. So now what we just did is, okay, we discovered that, okay, on daily chart, we are bullish on daily. Then I want to partake of this swing, but I want to ride it on a long term. That is why I place the trade on daily. But if I don't want to, if I know, okay, I don't have much to risk like that, I can go down to 1 hour and be waiting for a right buying set. I will not be going short, but I will be waiting on 1 hour like this.
Okay.
I'll be waiting on 1 hour for a proper bullish setup, and I will enter the trade. So it will just be something of this nature. Like, for example, like here now, you enter here, your stop loss will now be like 40 something below it.
Okay.
You understand now? And of course, you take profits like that. But like on daily chart now, this trade, I'm not expecting, in fact, this trade might not even close this week.
Oh, wow.
So now we are risking this 3,000, but if this goes on our favor and in my direction as forecasted and projected, this is how much I'm looking to make on this trade, $5,145.
Wow.
You see now, so with this $5,145, so let's assume you have this account that is $62,000 account. Many people have businesses. Okay, many people have, and I told you of someone that had a grocery Dollar General store, took a loan of almost $80,000 to set it up. Didn't use to make even an extra $1,000 a month.
Right.
Many people have so many businesses that costed them over $100,000 to set up. In a month, they don't have profit of $5,000.
True.
So this trade, let's assume even this is the only one trade I placed now in this month. And I monitor it. Of course, I will not leave my stop loss here the way it is forever. As this trade is continuing, also I will be moving. I will be moving my stop loss. I will be moving my stop loss. I will be moving my stop loss.
Okay.
So at worst, I might end up closing this trade at 3,000 or whatever. That is if it doesn't come against me.
Right.
But if you come against me, am I willing to risk 3,000 out of 60 something thousand? Yes. Because $3,000. Even if it goes, I will still be having $59,000 left.
Right.
Does that make sense now? But yeah. I'm not saying, okay, I have $62,000, then I go ahead and place this. I can place this same trade. If I want to place this same trade on 15 minutes or 5 minutes chart, I will not be placing 0.6 lot size. You see now where we're talking about. If I'm placing this trade now on this, let's say this is on this is 15 minutes now, I will not be placing this trade with 0.6. If I want to place this trade on 15 minutes, I will place almost 6.0 lot size.
Okay.
I can place this trade, use 6.0 lot size. Now, where my stop loss will be, my stop loss will be here, okay, somewhere here. I'll be risking just like a 50 pips. So 50 pips, and I'm placing a six lot size. So I'll still be risking almost that same amount, but my take profit in this case now will not be in that direction. My take profit will be, like if I enter this trade now, buy, this is where I'll be targeted to take my take profit, just right here. So right. I'll be looking into just like 20 pips. And trust me, 20 pips times 60, within some minutes thereabout, I'll be making almost 1,200 with this trade. And it's what I can actually place. Because it's actually a good setup. It's a good trade setup. Stop loss will come here, and I will just, you know, do a day trading with it.
Right.
So this is just all, it depends on you, it depends on your availability, it depends on what you want to do. The same market, like right now, daily, I will not, if let's assume this is the trade now that I place, I will not be coming to this trade every second to see what is going on. And even if the market is going and I see this thing as a minus 500 or even minus $1,000, trust me, I will not be freaked out to close it because I already set up my trade. And I'll let the trade do what it wants to do. Because the price closed above this 50 EMA and my stop loss is right down here. So I just let it ride. So this trade now can be on for the next 2 weeks. So if I'm a busy person, I mean, I just leave the trade and let the trade just do whatever it wants to do. So that is swing trading for you. That is how you swing trade. All right, welcome back, my friend. So as you can see from that video, it is very, very easy to make money with Tradermatic. You can scalp, you can day trade, and you can swing trade. Depends on your schedule, your lifestyle, and what is going on in your life. I mean, I did a series of training last week. If you missed any of those trainings, you can look into the description of this video, you're going to see a link to all of them. You can watch them all over again. And of course, I'm going to be hosting a special training. I call it Forex Manifesto. So in case you are busy and maybe you don't just want to, you don't really have time for the learning course involved in Forex, and you still want to, you know, partake of this national cake, you can actually make money from Forex or with Forex. So all you have to do is click or go to www.forexmanifesto.net, forexmanifesto.net, sign up for this training. I call it Forex Manifesto, and you're going to be learning or discovering 9 proven ways to make money from the Forex market. Okay, so let's pick our winner for the palliative cash gift for this week. So from the series of videos created last week, this is the winner. Okay, this video has a 323 views, and as you can see, we have 8 comments. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to go to our randomizer. Drum roll, let's be Odedina Oluwatoba, congratulations, you are the winner for this week's palliative cash gift. So you know how to get me, contact me on WhatsApp, and of course, after you receive your palliative cash gift, you're going to give us up to 30 seconds of video testimonial just to show that you got your money, and this is not just making it up. Okay, so thank you so much, my friend. I will see you tomorrow.